I think they all started out at even thousands. They had them each different so they could tell which was which. Well, I don't know about you, but I think I'll raid the pantry for some bite-sized stuff. I don't want to get a chance to use it maybe sometime.
Binoculars?
Need to maneuver.
Found it, huh?
We're going to take that in the way. Amazing how quickly you adapt. Well, that doesn't seem weird at all to me. Look out there and see the moon going by. You know? Oh,
I guess. Yeah, that's a crazy moon out there again, huh? Funny looking thing.
Well, this crazy bracket is right here. It's probably right the hell in your way, isn't it?
No.
Right. In your way?
No, I can survive with that.
Yeah, I mean, put that there, it'll be one less thing to do to me. It's been backwards, but I mean, it's...
Well, if I don't need this thing anymore, I think I'll throw that one away. Systems are yours tomorrow?
Yeah.
I don't know that we've got much to do as a purge.
Is it 84 hours yet? Yeah, it is. I'm going to dump the wastewater.
Boy, it's a dusty vehicle in there. But that view approaching the landing is just fantastic. Right out, right smack out the window. You know?
Yeah, yeah.
Except there was such a big shadow being cast by everything.
Oh,
that I really couldn't
make the
I can identify the cat paw, and I could identify the Terra crater right at the end. But I couldn't really make out the backward Z nor the three little curved ones on one side. But I could see the area where it all was, you know. And it didn't go any further back than this, didn't go any further forward than that. It was right there. And it was rougher than the cob.
but I think it's anyway.
Well, when you compare it with the surrounding area, is why it's pretty reasonable. You want this somewhere?
You don't mind, I put it on this big piece of Velcro over here by the fuel cell.
Yeah, that's the place for that.
Bar fact.
have any use for lateral in the lamb field?
Can't think of any use for two of them.
Great.
Thank you.
amazing. Blue towels? Did I dislodge those by mistake, or did you have those?
I had them out kind of floating around back here. There isn't anything you could dislodge. They forgot to put the filter on the damn thing.
Let me swap one. Figure out how you tell when one's gone. I think that was it. Yeah, it stopped.
Jackson right here.
This is Apollo Control Houston at 84 hours and 28 minutes, and now into the flight Apollo 11. We're less than 2 minutes away now from our scheduled time of acquisition with Apollo 11. Meanwhile, in Mission Control Center, astronaut Owen Garriott has now replaced Charlie Duke as our capsule communicator. We expect that some final advisories will be passed to the Apollo 11 crew, and final reports such as crew status will be received from Neil Armstrong, Mike Collins, and Buzz Aldrin prior to the start of their sleep period. We're a little over a minute away now from scheduled time of acquisition. We'll continue to keep the line up and continue to monitor. This is Apollo Control, Houston. Mark, 30 seconds now from time of scheduled acquisition. Mark, 20 seconds. Ten seconds. We should be acquiring shortly, and we're standing by. We have data. We've acquired data on Apollo 11. This is Apollo Control, Houston. Owen Garriott getting ready to place a call.
Over.
Houston, Apollo 11.
11, Houston. Roger, reading you fine, and it looks like the automatic react went very well just as soon as you came around the limb. We have several small items to discuss with you here just before you go to sleep. Over.
Go ahead, Orin.
Okay, 11. First of all, on our LEM systems checks, everything went fine. I would like to remind you, though, tomorrow you may see an ascent pressure light when you activate the MCNW. There should be no problem there, however. You did note that the app's aux tank pressure was only reading 111 PSI, which is normal at this point. But below the level which will trigger your light due to the helium which has been dissolved into the propellant. Over.
Roger, I understand that. Thank you.
Roger, and next item, the supercritical helium rise rate is nominal. And you also had questions for us about your thruster activity during the P-22 on the last rev. I believe we understand that now. As you reported, your pitch was in Excel command and your yaw and roll were in rate command. As you were firing your pitch thrusters, this will couple rates into your yaw and roll axes, and you were at that time holding only half a degree dead band, and coupling rates into yaw and roll produced the extra firings about the yaw and roll axes. Over.
Yeah, that may be true. It's very peculiar coupling in that it waits longer than you would think, and its reaction is greater than you would think. We were getting yaw rates of around 0.4 of a degree per second, for example.
Roger, Mike. We did play the data back, and that's the way it looked upon analysis of the chart recordings back here. Over.
Okay, fine.
They've also looked at the results of your landmark tracking. The marks all apparently were very good, and we've got a full page of data here relative to the altitudes of the various site locations, which I won't read up to you, but I did want to let you know that the marks apparently went very well. I also have your consumable budgets, particularly your RCS propellant quantities. They're deltas from nominal if you should want them. Your worst quad is Quad Charlie, which is 9% low. I'll not read up the others unless you want them. Over.
Okay, how about the O2 fuel cell purge? You want that now?
I'll have to stand by just a moment.
Okay, and then the other one is we're still charging battery A.
Houston, we would like to delay the fuel cell purge until the backside of the moon, and you go ahead and should terminate your battery charge at this time. Over.
Okay, I understand. I knew we had another O2 and H2 purge coming up in the morning. I wasn't sure whether you wanted to go through with this one or not. I'll wait until the backside and then do it.
That's fine,
Buzz. Terminate battery charging now.
That's right, and one other systems item here. In order to balance your cryo tanks, would you get your O2 tank 1 and your H2 tank 2 heaters off? Over.
Okay, I have O2 tank heater 1 off and H2 tank heater 2 off.
That's right, Mike, and we believe you have your quad Bravo and quad Charlie turned off in your DAP at this time in a 5-degree dead band. We'd prefer a 10-degree dead band for your sleep period overnight here. Over.
Okay.
One other item relative to a malfunction procedure. It's unlikely that you'll have to worry about this tomorrow, but in your malfunction list under docking on page F11-9, there is a malfunction procedure for a high O2 flow rate at the top of, under tunnel, at the top of page 11-9. We would like to have you not use that malfunction procedure should you encounter the high O2 flow rate, and instead check back with Houston for a revised procedure should you find that situation. Over.
Understand, and a note has been made in my checklist.
Levin Houston, Roger, that just about takes care of all the items we have here on the ground before time to hit the FEC, and I guess you will have a pre-sleep check for us before you go to bed.
Roger, we're in the midst of cycling the O2 and H2 fans now.
Roger.
And the radiation is as follows, CDR 11012, CMP 10013, LMP 09015. Negative medication, over.
Roger, copy, 11.
This is Apollo Control, Houston. 84 hours, 39 minutes now into the flight. That conversational exchange with Owen Garriott here in Mission Control Center, and principally Buzz Aldrin. However, Mike Collins did talk briefly about Program 22, the landmark tracking activity in which he performed. At 84 hours, 40 minutes, this is Apollo Control, Houston.
Houston, Apollo 11.
11, Houston, go ahead.
All right, we're thinking about taking the monocular with us on into the LEM. We think it might prove to be of some use, over.
Roger, Buzz. It sounds like a good idea for some of your surveying work there inside the cockpit, over.
Okay, you want to run that by whoever might be concerned?
I sure will.
This is Apollo Control, Houston, 84 hours, 44 minutes, and now into the flight Apollo 11. Our current spacecraft altitude, now 64.3 nautical miles, with an apolune of 65.2 nautical miles, perilune 54.4 nautical miles. We show an orbital period of 1 hour, 58 minutes, 40 seconds on our displays. Current weight of the spacecraft in orbit, 70,502 pounds. at 84 hours, 44 minutes, continuing to monitor. This is Apollo Control, Houston. This is Apollo Control, Houston, 84 hours, 48 minutes, now into the flight. We're receiving noisy data at this time. We have requested Apollo 11 to give us a manual relock. Standing by at 84 hours, 49 minutes. This is Apollo Control, Houston.
these are the good ones. You should be able to find us there. Over.
Houston, Apollo 11, how do you right now?
11, Houston, loud and clear this time, how many?
Loud and clear, you faded out on your last transmission, over.
Roger, are you in wide beam now?
Negative, I got you locked back on again, REAC, and now.
Roger, that's what we want. We want to stay in narrow, and we're a little puzzled about why we lost you here a few minutes ago. Do you have any ideas?
No, sure don't. We're showing about 15 degrees plus pitch and about 270. That ought to be good and clear.
We concur there. We still don't have any good ideas on why we were lost. Houston, would you confirm that we did acquire automatically when you came around the limb for this passage? Over.
That's confirmed.
Thank you.
This is Apollo Control, Houston, 84 hours, 56 minutes now into the flight, Apollo 11. Our current Apolloon, 65.1 nautical miles, current Paraloon, 54.3 nautical miles. After receiving some noisy signal, Apollo 11 has locked back on in fine form. That was Buzz Aldrin speaking with Owen Garriott here in the Mission Control Center. I expect we will take a second look at why we had to lock on manually. As we receive any updates on this, we'll pass them along. We now read 84 hours, 57 minutes. And this is Apollo Control, Houston.
Apollo 11 Houston, over.
Houston, Apollo 11.
11 Houston, on your auto RTS select switches, we show Quad Bravo disabled, but Quad Charlie only partially disabled. Charlie 3, I believe, is the only one you have selected off. Is that correct?
No, Roger, that's correct.
Roger.
This is Apollo Control Houston, 85 hours, 5 minutes, and now to the flight Apollo 11. We confirm from the ground following that conversational exchange. As was pointed out,
we see them all disabled at this time. Thank you.
As was pointed out, RCS Quad Charlie is now disabled following that conversational exchange between Owen Garriott and Buzz Aldrin. Buzz, the lunar module pilot, apparently quite obviously still awake. 85 hours, 7 minutes now to the flight Apollo 11. Continuing to monitor, this is Apollo Control Houston.
Apollo 11, Houston, over.
Go ahead, Houston.
11, Houston, we're going to try to check out this ability to automatically reacquire on the S-band. And what we want to do is to secure our uplink carrier for about 30 seconds. Then we will turn it back on and see if the spacecraft equipment will automatically reacquire. So if you do not get a call from us within about 3 minutes, that means we have not been able to reacquire, and request your assistance on a manual acquisition. Over.
Okay, we understand.
Levin Houston, we also appreciate if you will note the angles that the antenna tracks through in its attempt to reacquire. Over.
Roger, we'll do that.
Levin Houston, it looks like we're locked back up again with no delay. How does it look on board? Over.
Roger. The signal strength dropped very rapidly to zero, and the pitch and yaw in about 3 seconds moved toward 40 degrees pitch and 240 degrees yaw. Right now, they're setting on about 15 degrees pitch and about 265 degrees yaw. So they didn't move very far, about 30 degrees apiece. And then they picked right back on up again, over.
Roger, some of the luckiest people in the background there. We copied your pitch and yaw angles. 11 Houston, could you give us the location of your pitch and yaw location of your position indicators? Over.
Roger, they're in the same position as the antenna right now. Plus 15 degrees pitch and well, now wait a minute. I got them, got it at about 275 instead of 265.
Okay, thank you. Houston, we'd like to try the same procedure once more. We'll leave the carrier off a little longer and be back up for a call within 4 minutes. Over.
Okay.
This is Apollo Control, Houston, 85 hours, 17 minutes now into the flight Apollo 11. What you heard in the conversation between Owen Garriott and Buzz Aldrin was following a communications check in which we secured the uplink carrier for some 30 seconds and waited a given period of time, approximately 3 minutes, to see if the spacecraft would reacquire. We appeared to reacquire in fine form on this first test. We will repeat it, this test a second time, delaying approximately 4 minutes before we place a call to Apollo 11. At 85 hours, 17 minutes, we currently read an altitude, spacecraft altitude of 56.1 nautical miles. Present velocity shows 5,367 feet per second. An apolune, 65 nautical miles. Paraloon, 54.4 nautical miles. Present weight in orbit remains a static 70,502 pounds. Present time in orbit, as shown on our displays, 1 hour, 58 minutes, 40 seconds. This is Apollo Control, Houston.
Houston, we're locked back up again. Can you give us a report on how the antenna behaves?
Roger, it was essentially identical with before. The pitch went to 45, 40 to 45, and the yaw went to about 255 to 255, and then it rather quickly locked up that 15 degrees pitch and 270 yaw.
11 Houston, roger your angles, 45 and 255. Do I understand that as soon as the carrier dropped, it went to these angles, or did it only go to these angles after the uplink carrier was re-enabled and the antenna began to hunt to reacquire? Over.
Now, as soon as the carrier dropped off, well, it drifted over to those angles and stayed there. And then when it came back up again, well, it hunted around for a while but didn't get any further off. It gradually brought it on into the angles where it is right now, and then the signal strength would take several jumps as evidently it goes from wide to medium to narrow. Over.
11 Houston, understand. And on another subject, request you zero your optics for the night. Over.
Roger. Zero.
This is Apollo Control Houston at 85 hours, 27 minutes now into the flight Apollo 11. We've run two tests thus far with the S-band antenna, which is reacquired nicely on both occasions. We're standing by for further possible conversations with the crew at this time. We're some 15 minutes away from predicted time of loss of signal on Apollo 11. Currently, we read an apolune of 65 nautical miles, a perilune of 54.4 nautical miles. This is Apollo Control Houston.
Apollo 11, Houston, can you confirm that you have changed the CO2 filter as per flight plan in the last hour? Over.
No, we're still eating. We're about to do it. We'll let you know.
Roger, 11, and we've got about 14 minutes to LOS. AOS is 86.30. An hour away. We are wondering whether or not you plan to have one man up at that time, or would you all like to be asleep inside the next hour? Over.
Somebody will be up.
Roger. The thing that we're still puzzling on is the antenna, and if as long as there will be somebody up, why we would like to have somebody check the automatic REAC on the next AOS.
Okay, we'll do that. And we haven't chlorinated the water yet, and we haven't changed the lithium hydroxide. We're just still finishing up dinner.
Roger, Mike. Thank you.
This is Apollo Control Houston, 85 hours, 29 minutes now into the flight. That was Mike Collins reporting to capsule communicator Owen Garriott that the Apollo 11 crew completing dinner at this time. And earlier, perhaps, as you listened to the air ground, you heard some music in the background, soft music, which would indicate that this was being played in concert with their evening meal. When we reacquire, we expect one of the three crew members to still be, at least one, to be still awake as we run a further check on our spacecraft antenna. At 85 hours, 30 minutes into the flight of Apollo 11, this is Apollo Control Houston. Thank you. This is Apollo Control, Houston.
West coming up in 2 minutes now, and AOS will be at 86 plus 28 plus 15. Over.
We'll see you on the other side.
Roger.
Hours, 40 minutes at this time. Perhaps the last conversation we'll have with Apollo 11 until we reacquire. We're now 1 minute, 20 seconds away from loss of signal. Continuing to stand by, this is Apollo Control, Houston, at 85 hours, 41 minutes. This is Apollo Control, Houston. We've had loss of signal as the Apollo 11 spacecraft begins its pass around the far side of the moon. At 85 hours, 42 minutes.
Everybody through the water?
Yeah, go ahead.
Doc?
Nope.
Doc, hey, remember when they told us about that putting buttons on the seat of these pants?
No, I don't remember.
Yeah, they were working up this elaborate scheme.
Or you had your choice between that and Velcro. What'd you choose? I mean, don't get me hanging.
Well, whatever I chose, they didn't give me.
Didn't have anything.
Nothing
of
it. They told me you guys had Velcro on you.
Mm-hmm.
Maybe on the other side.
I guess. That's a pair of jockey shorts. Yeah, just cut the legs off. Lace off.
Yeah, I guess it's good.
How'd you sleep last night, Buzz, up on top? you open up the outer one, and you put the inner one in there and squeeze it and it breaks. And then you got to take the jet and go by the inspection and mush it all up. You get that stuff evenly distributed to it. Let you guys sleep underneath tonight. I'll just stop this.
Yeah,
that's right. Unless you'd rather sleep up top, Buzz. You guys ought to get a good night's sleep wearing that damn limb. How about, which would you prefer? Was that probe and drug going to be in your way over there? Well, take your drugs, whichever you prefer.
Thank you.
Both green and flag. Yeah, I got a bunch. The well on us today went pretty well. Tomorrow the next day, like today, it was a good day.
Thank you.
me get a picture of it, because it's really a big group down the bottom.
Stop this way.
Go ahead.
Yeah.
I'm not sure I should be shooting it. What we're shooting at are 125th. I guess we're all right. And this light stuff, I guess we're all right.
Thank you.
Oops.
You want some more? All
right.
that we created a wall to scallop inside, like a design in a fan, like feathers.
Two shells.
Yeah.
That's two shells, you know, very pretty, very symmetrical. Took overlapping pictures of all that line as well. Yeah, I want to take, have to carry a lot of film to take as many pictures as I want. Okay, let me go do that. Do I know what ALS is? Yeah.
Black and white.
The color went right in there. I ran a temporary short drive. Ran a temporary short drive with the color.
Dark flight, I think right over there in the good show.
Yeah.
This is Apollo Control Houston. We're now less than 2 minutes away from acquisition of signal on Apollo 11 and in Mission Control Center Houston. We're standing by.
That's normal.
Mark, 1 minute from predicted acquisition of signal. We should be acquiring. We're standing by.
Another massive alarm coming in here. F8 is 250 at infinity. Good deal. Keep clicking, we got a lot of room.
Now the booster is
good deal.
Good.
Yeah. Good. 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 A lot of bills. They're building the lily.
Houston, loud and clear here, over.
Okay, we just appeared to get a solid lock for the last, about a minute. The Tunfermax needles have been wandering up and down, and the pitching needles have been wandering around, but it appears to have reacquired by itself solidly now. We're just finishing up our fuel cell purge. Hydrogen on number 3 is the last to go off. It'll be coming off just in a second.
Roger, 11. Apollo 11, Houston, we believe we've tracked down the reacquisition problem we had on the previous rev. It looks like it was a receiver power supply here on the ground, and no problems in the spacecraft at all, over.
Okay, go ahead here.
11, that really winds things up as far as we're concerned on the ground for the evening. We're ready to go to bed and get a little sleep, over.
Yeah, we're about to join you.
Roger.
This is Apollo Control, Houston, 86 hours, 33 minutes. You heard that last exchange. The Mission Control Center has isolated our earlier loss of lock on with the S-band antenna to a faulty power supply at Goldstone, which in turn introduced noisy data, causing a ground-based receiver to go out of lock. This power supply, a 24-volt one, has already been replaced at Goldstone. In summary, the spacecraft looks good, and the difficulty was caused here on the ground. At 86 hours, 34 minutes, we now read our orbit at 64.9 nautical miles apolune, 54.6 nautical miles perilune. This is Apollo Control, Houston.
Thank you.
This is Apollo Control Houston at 86 hours, 52 minutes, and now into the flight Apollo 11. Our current altitude on the Apollo 11 spacecraft now reads 64.9 nautical miles. This corresponds with our Apolloon of 64.9 nautical miles. Our Paraloon on this pass, 54.6 nautical miles. We've had no further conversation with the Apollo 11 crew, nor do we expect to do so. We will take the loop down at this time and stand by if any further conversation should develop. At 86 hours, 53 minutes into the flight, this is Apollo Control, Houston.